Hello students, welcome back. So we were discussing about the product of electrolysis and we have seen how the different products are getting formed on the electrolysis of an electrolyte on the basis of the E0 values. Okay, so now we'll discuss the Faraday's laws, who has given the quantitative relationship between the charge passed, okay, and then how much amount of electrolyte you can say it is getting deposited. Fine, so we'll see the relationship between the quantity of the charge passed and then how much amount of the electrolyte is getting liberated, or you can say that getting deposited at the respective electrodes. So this can be studied by Faraday's laws of electrolysis. Okay, given by Michael Faraday. Okay, so two laws he has given. Fine. He has given these laws in the year 1884. So two laws he has given, and both the laws, they are representing the quantity relationship between quantity of charge passed and amount of electrolyte deposited or liberated. Okay, so he has given two laws. Let's see first law of Faraday's. Okay, so first law of Faraday's, according to first law of Faraday's, the mass of an electrolyte deposited is directly proportional to the quantity of the charge passed. Quantity of the charge passed. So whatever the amount of charge has been passed, okay, accordingly the mass or the weight of the electrolyte will get deposited or liberated at the respective electrode. Suppose if we have passed like 5 Faradays of charge, then accordingly the amount will get deposited. Fine. So according to, let's see, this is a qualitative form. Let's see the quantitative mathematical form. The mass of an electrolyte deposited is directly proportional to the quantity of the charge passed. So mathematically means, how it is related mathematically, that is W is a, let's say W is a mass of the substance, okay, which is directly proportional to the quantity of the charge passed, that is Q. Okay, so here Q is the charge and W is the weight of an electrolyte. Fine. Now let's modify this. Okay. So let's modify. So we have seen that W is directly proportional to Q, and we know that the charge, that is Q, is the product of current into time. Okay, it's a product of current into time. So W is directly proportional to I into T. So when we remove this proportionality sign, we'll get Z, IT, where Z is known as electrochemical equivalent, and this is constant here. Electrochemical equivalent. Now what is the meaning of this? Suppose when charge of, when I is equal, or you can say charge of 1 coulomb, okay, say Q is equal to 1, okay, it means I is equal to 1 ampere and T is equal to 1 second. So we can say that when, you can say that when current of 1 ampere is passed for 1 second through the electrolyte, then W is the amount of the substance which gets deposited at the electrode. So how Z is, you can say how Z is defined as, Z is defined as the, because it is equal to W, so substitute here, you will get W is equal to Z. So how we will define Z now? Z is defined as the mass of an electrolyte deposited when current of 1 ampere is passed for 1 second. So this is the meaning of electrochemical equivalent. Fine. So this is about the first law, and this is a mathematical form, that is W is equal to ZIT. Okay. So now let's see, derive the another expression by considering the reaction. So let's consider the reaction. Consider the reaction, that is Mn positive is accepting an electrons and gives you M in the solid form. Now let A be the mass of an element. Okay, A is the atomic mass of the element M. Okay, that is atomic mass of the element M, and N is the valency, or you can say number of moles of electrons takes part in the reaction. Fine. Now we have seen that Faraday's, okay, what is that Faraday? So we know that charge on one electron, let's see this first, charge on one electron is equal to what? 1.602 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. This is a charge on one electron, and we know that what is Avogadro's number? 1 mole is equal to what? 6.022 into 10 to the power 22 per mole. Okay. So now can we calculate charge on 1 mole of electrons? So just multiply this charge by 1 mole into 6.022 into 10 to the power 22 per mole. So when you will multiply, you will get 96472 coulomb per mole, which is nearly equal to 96500 coulomb per mole. This is what we are taking as 1 Faraday. This is Faraday's constant. Faraday's constant means this has been given by the Faraday only, the in his laws, Faraday's laws. So this is coming from here, that we have used in that relation also, delta G is equal to minus NF E naught cell. Delta G naught is equal to minus NF E naught cell. So this is charge on 1 mole of electron. So this is that value, that is a fixed quantity. Constant one, this is also constant and this is also constant. Fine. Now let's derive the another expression by using this. Fine. Now can we say that this coulomb of charge will deposit how much amount of the element? Okay. So let's see. A, we have let the mass of the element. So let's say if N into this much charge, N into 96500 charge will deposit A gram of element M. Fine. Then 1 coulomb of charge will deposit how much? A divided by N into 96500 gram of element M. Fine. Then and we know that 1 coulomb of charge will deposit 1 coulomb कूलम ऑफ चार्ज विल डिपॉजिट मास ऑफ एलिमेंट दैट इज इक्वल टू जेड. वी हैव सीन अबव व्हेन आई इज इक्वल टू वन एंड टाइम इज वन सेकेंड. सो डब्ल्यू इज कमिंग आउट टू बी, दैट इज द वेट ऑफ द एलिमेंट इज कमिंग आउट टू बी जेड. सो दिस इज जेड. सो कैन वी सब्स्टिट्यूट हियर, जेड इज इक्वल टू ए डिवाइडेड बाय एन इंटू 96500. फाइन. नाउ हियर ए बाय एन, दैट इज एटॉमिक मास बाय एन. ए बाय एन इज एयर ई विच इज द इक्विवेलेंट मास. What is equivalent mass? Equivalent mass is defined as the it's a ratio of the atomic mass of the element, or either molar mass, or the you can say formula mass of the, or the mass of the ion divided by its valency. Valency of the ion, element, anything, whatever is present. So it is A by N. So A by N is, that is atomic mass by valency. N is valency, or the number of electrons involved is equal to Z. This is known as equivalent mass. Okay, so we'll substitute here, but we will get Z is equal to E divided by 96500. Further, if you will modify, you will get E is equal to Z into 96500. So this is the relationship between E and Z, where E is the equivalent mass and Z is the electrochemical equivalent. Okay, so fine. So this is the, you can say this formula you can use in the solving the numericals on the basis of Faraday's first law. So again, we can see if this is a reaction, reduction reaction. So if we can say that N into, that is N is the number of electrons involved, N is 96500 charge will deposit if a gram of the element M, then 1 coulomb of charge will deposit this amount. Then if we know that 1 coulomb of charge will deposit mass of element that is equal to Z, we have seen. So if Z is equal to this quantity, and this A by N ratio is the equivalent mass, which is the ratio you can see of atomic mass divided by its valency, or the number of electrons involved, whatever the species is there. So accordingly, when you will substitute here, you will get the relationship between E and Z. That is, E is the product of 1 Faraday into Z. That is electrochemical equivalent. Fine. So this is all about the first law. Now let's see the second law of Faraday's. Okay, Faraday's second law. Now Faraday's second law is also based on the first law only, but the thing is that we'll take two different electrolytes. Here we have talked about only for one electrolyte, that mass of the amount of an electrolyte gets deposited is directly proportional to the quantity of the charge passed. So this only will be applying there. So Faraday's second law of electrolysis. Okay, this states that when same amount of electricity is passed through the solutions of two different electrolytes, two different electrolytes connected in series, then the amount of the electrolyte deposited is equal to their electrochemical equivalent. Okay. Now let's see what is the meaning. See, the quantity of the charge of electricity that we are passing, that is same charge is getting passed, but the solutions are different, two different electrolytes we have taken, and they are connected in series. Okay, so whatever the amount of electrolyte get deposited there, so that is equal to their electrochemical equivalent. So let's see, two different cells are there, and in that two different solutions of electrolyte we have taken. Fine, let's say this is silver nitrate solution, this is copper sulfate solution. Fine. And how they are connected? They are connected with the help of wire. And then these are connected with the help of battery. Okay. So this is your positive, this is negative. This is negative, so this is positive. Okay, oppositely charged. Fine. So they are connected in series. And they are connected here with the help of the wires. Okay. This is plus. This is minus. As you know that. So this is the meaning of this. Now let's see mathematically. Okay. So same amount of charge is passed and two different solutions are there. So whatever the amount of the electrolyte get deposited, that will be equal to their electrochemical equivalent. So let's see mathematically means what? So mathematically, you can say, and both the laws of Faraday's are very, very important. That statement direct will come in exam. They'll not ask that write first law. They will say only Faraday's first law of electrolysis. That means you have to write both the laws. Fine. And the numericals are important. So mass of copper deposited divided by mass of silver deposited equal to their, that is Z of copper and Z of silver. So this is the meaning. And if we apply, we can also derive the first law, second law from the first one. So according to first law W directly proportional to Q. So apply this for different electrolytes. So W1 is directly proportional to Q. W2 is directly proportional to Q. So this is first and this is second. Fine. So W1 is equal to ZQ. This is Z1. W2 is equal to Z2Q. Okay. Now you just divide these. So QQ, why Q is same? Because same charge is getting passed. Then only the mass is getting, you can say it is proportional to their electrochemical equivalent. Okay. So what we will get from here? That W1 by W2 is equal to Z1 by Z2. QQ get cancelled out. Fine, again Z is, you can say, related to what? We know that Z is equal to E is equal to Z into 96500. So Z1 is equal to E1 divided by 96500 and Z2 is equal to E2 divided by 96500. Again this will get cancelled out, then you will left with W1 by W2 is equal to E1 by E2. So this is the mathematical form of the Faraday's second law. Okay, that masses of both the electrolytes are proportional to their electrochemical equivalent or equivalent masses. Equivalent and equivalent masses. Fine. So this is about the second law. I hope both the laws are clear. First law we have seen that whatever the quantity of charge we are passing, accordingly the mass of the electrolyte will get deposited. And in the second one we have seen that when we are passing the same charge to the solution of two different electrolytes, then we have seen the masses of their electrolyte, whatever is getting deposited, is proportional to their electrochemical equivalent or their equivalent masses. Fine. Now we will solve the numerical. So let's see the numerical of this. Okay. So let's see the question. Calculate the number of coulombs required. Calculate the number of coulombs required to deposit 40.5 gram of aluminium when the electrode reaction is given Al 3 positive 3 electrons gives you aluminium. Now what you have to do, you have to calculate the charge, number of coulombs required. Okay, so let's see the charge Q on the n moles of electron. Okay, that is charge Q present on n mole of electrons is given by what? NF. So what is n here? Here n is 3 electrons and F you know 96500. Fine. So now let's see the, when you will multiply this, Q is equal to 3 into 96500. Coulomb will come. Okay. So, and we know that molar mass of aluminium is 27 gram per mole. So, if 27 gram of aluminium will require this charge, then 1 gram will require, 27 gram from the reaction. 27 gram of aluminium requires this charge, 3F. Okay, then 1 gram will require 289500 divided by 27 coulomb, then 40.5 gram aluminium require, multiply by that 27 into 40.5, and you will solve this, then you will get the value 4.342 into 10 to the power 5 coulomb. What you will get? 4.342 into 10 to the power 5 coulomb. This is the answer. In this way you have to solve by applying the unitary method, or you can apply the formula also that we have seen. Okay, that A upon N into 96500, where A is atomic mass. Okay, so accordingly you just calculate. Fine, in this way you can solve number of numericals on the basis of the Faraday's laws of electrolysis. Fine, I hope I am clear. Fine, so we'll see the next topic. So here we have finished with the second part of the electrochemistry. Now in the next class we'll start with the last part of the electrochemistry, that is your electrolytic conduction. Fine, till then thank you and have a nice day.